my BMW to 500 horsepower. Was this a mistake?
But first, we need to get rid of these stock grills. And I have just the idea.
Fire and low.
Well, there we go. That did the trick. All right, now we got the new M3 style. Just line her up and... that looks so much better. Easy install. Well, here it is, my BMW budget build supercar killer sedan. That's right. Was it worth putting all the time and all the money and the effort into this car? Well, today we're gonna answer that question. Now, whether you own one of these already or maybe you're thinking about picking one up, well, hopefully this video will give you a good understanding of, is it even fucking worth it? Well, let's start with the mods. Ugh. Alrighty. So what did I do to this car? What are all the mods? Well, the first thing that you could probably tell is this air cleaner right here. This is my cold air intake. Now I already know some of you guys are gonna be butthurt in the comments saying it's a hot air intake. All right, it looks cooler, and I didn't wanna pay for all the plumbing that goes into here. So this is one of the first mods I did. Second up, I have a charge pipe. See right there? That is an aluminum charge pipe, this thing right here with these clamps on it. Now, I did that because the plastic one bursts all the time in these cars, and then you lose all your boost. So that was the second mod that I did. All right, next mod. Oh no!
What?
Dude, this thing came completely off. Look, it's completely melting.
That isn't the cool line, is it?
No, this is the cool line. That already exploded on me once. This is just the hood latch. So if this breaks, then I won't be able to open the hood.
Here, just zip tie it.
Yeah, I'm gonna get some zip ties and we'll clean this up real quick. All right, so tip number one is if you own a BMW, make sure you have a large quantity of zip ties in your garage. They'll come in handy. So we'll zip tie this. Oh, this rubber's not coming off my hands. So there's one. There we go. All good. You're welcome, next owner. All right, well, now that that's taken care of, next mod I did was a catless downpipe, really deep into there. And what's really nice about these motors is it likes to leak, right? The valve cover and drips right onto that downpipe. So everyone at the signal is looking at you because your car's smoking, but that's okay. It's a BMW thing. And after that, well, I just did basic coil replacement and spark plugs, one step colder for the tune. The rest of the stuff is pretty much stock and all pretty much leaking. All right, that's it up top. Let me go into some of the other mods I did. All right, well, next mod I did was this VRSF intercooler, which is kind of essential if you're doing stage two of any sort, 91 octane, 93, E85, E30. That intercooler is helping getting colder air into the turbo for better performance. Let's go check the rear end. Dude, my tires are chewed the fuck up. Holy shit. All right, and the last performance mod that I pretty much did physically to the car was, well, this is a budget build, and in the essence of keeping it a budget build, I can't spend $1,500 for an axle back or a cat back exhaust. So what I did is I made my own valved exhaust. The cops here in California are mighty strict, so this does the job quite nicely. It's just a valve that was welded into the side of my existing exhaust. So when I open that, I'm pretty much getting a straight pipe sound, especially with that catless downpipe up front. All right, well, here's how it sounds. Take a listen.
Fire in the hole. I think it's time Lenny finally gets a V8, other than the Jag.
Okay, I'm not making any promises here, okay? So don't hold me to it, but I may or may not be looking to liquidate this and get myself into something with two more cylinders and an extra turbo. So comment down below if you think you know what I may be hinting at. It's not that I don't love this car, it's just I may be wanting a little bit more torque, a little bit more horsepower, and honestly, I'm a V8 kind of guy. And I think this inline six has just served me long enough. So time to say goodbye to these lame burbles and maybe getting a bigger upgrade. So comment down below if you think you know what I'm talking about. Okay, let's get the hell out of here before we get arrested. All right, well, there you go. There's kind of the rundown of all the mods. And later in this video, you'll see that we're actually gonna go out to Mexico and test it out. But for right now, let's go over all the problems. Okay, so the first major problem that has been cursing me for a very long time, well, is this plastic valve cover. You know, in American cars, you have metal valve covers, but this plastic hunk of shit warps and cracks over time. So what happens is it likes to drip along the side here. It's a slant six. All the oil collects in the side of the valve cover. And they even include this little drip tray because they knew it was gonna leak eventually. Very nice of BMW. But what ends up happening is it funnels right down on my downpipe and creates plumes of smoke. So the other major problem is that this oil filter housing likes to absolutely gush out oil. Okay, that might not seem like a horrible problem, but what that means is it's dripping right down onto my serpentine belt. And what happens is that serpentine belt gets nice and wet and slick, slips off and gets sucked into the engine and the motor goes kaboom. Not a big deal, right? Well, here's the thing. In order to fix this gasket, you have to remove the entire intake manifold, replace all the gaskets in the intake manifold, disassemble basically the top end of the motor, get rid of all your fluids, and when you're reassembling, if you don't prime it correctly, you might spin a bearing. Pretty neat stuff. Oh. Now you may think we're done because I'm putting this back on. No, no, no. So one of the other major problems, as you can tell right here, my radiator has a hairline crack in it. So I'm basically waiting for this thing to burst and give me third degree burns at any moment now. And with that being said, let's go down under, check out some more of the problems. All right, so it looks like we have a little bit of leak on some of the turbo drainage lines. I think it's like the return line. There's a little bit of oil just dripping on the exhaust like I talked about. There's a little bit of oil down over here on the intercooler, and look, even on this control arm, there's some really black looking oil. Damn, that feels like brake fluid. It didn't feel like oil. I don't know. Hey, can you see if it's leaking on top by the valve cover?
Yeah. Yeah.
What the f?
What? What? Oh my god, what the hell happened? Oh, dude, you got oil everywhere.
That's you gotta be careful when you're working on your Beamer.
What the hell, dude? All over the concrete.
I was just down under there. And I just touched it and it broke the line. It just burst. I think it was off the turbo. Oh.
Sometime later.
I just listed all these terrible catastrophic problems that I should really address. Well, this is a budget build, and with the nature of a budget build, there's no money for fixing oil leaks. So let's go take it out to Mexico and rip the ever-living shit out of it. This is an experiment for you guys. Let's go. Now that we are in the remote parts of the Mexican mountains, let's see if this BMW can do donuts. Oh, all right. We made it. We are out in the middle of the Mexican mountains to show you guys if all these mods were worth doing. We're gonna be answering the age old question was, you know, are we gonna actually see that all this power is gonna translate to the rear wheels to get us a better 0-60 time? Well, I sure hope so because it was a lot of money and time, and we have a perfect straight shot right now for a 0-60. So I think we should set up the cameras, set up the clocks, and get rolling. Okay, so. Start her up. She's already warm, had a long drive here. Put her in sport mode. We have the check engine light, so that should help with the power. And we're gonna pull out to our straight line. So we're gonna start right where this white line is right here. Set?
Yeah.
All right, 3, 2, 1. So that is an amazing 0-60 at 5.9 seconds. So either this thing is extremely inaccurate or I got ripped off. So I think we're gonna do this again because that's depressing.
It was not a good launch.
It was not a good launch. And also I didn't use the paddles because I was one hand driving already. So let's reset take two and we're gonna beat that time because that is worse than stock.
There's also two guys in the car.
There's also two guys, a trunk full of stuff, and I'm using a GPS-actuated phone recorder. All right, this is take two. This time I'm actually gonna be shifting it myself and Noah is gonna be recording on the phone, so. Are we ready?
Yep. And we got a 5.9
again?
Yeah.
All right, dude, well, this doesn't look too good. I'm a little dumbfounded. 5.9 is, I think EcoBoosts are quicker than 5.9. So I don't really know what's going on. I think I may have gotten scammed.
Maybe time for a better Beamer.
Maybe time for an upgrade because that is awfully depressing. You know, I think what we need to test this out one more time. Okay, so here's what I think. That's awful. And here's what really matters. What's my eighth mile or quarter mile time? So I think we're gonna, the best bet is before I get rid of this car, we take this to a drag strip and we get some real official times. Because I don't know the accuracy of my phone. It's probably like 3 seconds behind, which is really gonna make it a 3.9 seconds, 0-60. That's probably what it really is. But we're just gonna say we're gonna go to the drag strip. We're gonna get some more accurate times to better represent the car and the build. Because I really hope this, 5.9, it's not real. It's a mistake in the calculation. I'm not gonna even worry about it. When we get to the drag strip in the next episode, guys, we're gonna really test it out. And hopefully that eighth mile is impressive because I'm a little upset right now.
Well, Lenny left me stranded out here, so now we gotta wait for him to come back. But between you and me, I am so sick of that fucking piece of shit Beamer always breaking. I don't know why he can't just get a reliable car. I'm trying to convince him to dump that piece of shit and get something much nicer with a big old rumbling V8, even if it is another fucking Beamer. Something with more cylinders, something with more turbos, more power. Now that I got the Mustang 5.0, I've got the fastest car out of us. So we're gonna take the Mustang 5.0 and his crummy Beamer to the drag strip. Oh, here it comes. I think it's time for an upgrade. By the way, we just picked up this bad boy, and this is making about 500 horsepower right now, but soon to be 800, the supercharger on its way. So stay tuned, because next video, we're gonna burn the tires on this thing.
There you guys have it. We took it out, we did some tests. You know, I wanna do more tests. We're gonna be going to the Urbandale drag strip very soon, getting its final last hoorah, but I think I'm very seriously considering about buying a new vehicle. Like I said, two extra cylinders, an extra turbo. Let me know if you can guess what I'm throwing out here. But overall, this car really has never left me stranded. It's been a great daily driver. I've put a ton of miles on it. It's not, you know, it wasn't amazing when I started with it, and we've kind of modified the shit out of it, and it's done pretty well. I mean, everything from awful bolt-ons to a tune, everything basically but big turbos. Let me know what you guys want to see next. I'm going for horsepower here. I want major horsepower, and I just, you know, I don't know if this motor can really give me what I want. I think we may have to start on a different platform, if you know what I'm saying. So stay tuned, because Noah will be bringing out his Mustang to the drag strip. We'll be putting these two side by side and really trying to get a good eyeball test and really be getting a good understanding of, you know, what car is really quicker. And then we'll go from there. We'll have to compare them. Who do you want to win? Better be me.
So for a quick update for the Jag, also known as the General T, we got a new motor for it. And this was only $100. So just bear with me. We thought it was a 383 small block because that's what we were told. We thought, oh, we'll throw this in the Jag and just, you know, just roast the tires. Unfortunately, upon further examination, it turns out it is not a 383. It's just a normal stock 350 with some of the worst heads, smog heads you could possibly get, stock pistons, everything, and it's a two bolt main. So we're gonna go throw this off a cliff or something. Yeah, this thing's basically worthless. But it looks nice, so.
Yeah, it looks nice, but I mean, absolute junker right here. I mean, I don't think we could sell this for a few crackers if we wanted to.
I'm sure it runs, but we'll see what we can do with it. So unfortunately, we wanted a good motor, but that's how it goes.